To my brothers and sisters in the Evangelical Presbyterian Church, grace and peace to you and our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Dean Weaver, and I am humbled to serve you as the stated clerk of the EPC. And I'd like to take a moment to share with not only all of our members, but for those who are particularly going to be commissioners at our 42nd General Assembly coming up at Ward EPC Church in Northville, Michigan, about a couple of important items that are going to be before the General Assembly. Two in particular that come from our national leadership team. And today I would like to speak to recommendation 42-10. That recommendation coming from the NLT is a recommendation that the Assembly approve a moderator-appointed Ad Interim Committee to write a pastoral letter of racial lament and hope. A pastoral letter of racial lament and hope. Let me unpack all of that recommendation just for but a second. First of all, a moderator-appointed Ad Interim Committee. That means that our outgoing moderator, Brad Strait, would work to appoint a representative group of people to seek the mind of Christ and represent the EPC in this pastoral letter. An Ad Interim Committee means that it reports directly to the General Assembly. It would likely have a two-year lifespan with an interim report at next year's General Assembly. And so it answers directly to the General Assembly. A pastoral letter is an inward-facing document. It's for our pastors and for our churches to give them pastoral guidance on a particular issue so that they can be better pastors. That's basically what it is. The most recent pastoral letter that we did was a pastoral letter on human sexuality. And it's an exceedingly helpful document to guide and shape pastors as they think about caring for those people in their brokenness in their communities around the issues of human sexuality. Well, it's no surprise that the world in which we live, the issues of racial inequity and injustice are huge for many of our churches and our communities. And so to be able to give a thoroughly biblical, ironic, and pastoral letter inside the church on what the Bible says about these things, not what people from outside the church say. We're not going to be concerned with language from outside the church and other systems. We want to be able to speak to a pastoral issue with biblical clarity and with a kind of gracious orthodoxy that the EPC has become noted for. Now, in our history in the EPC, we have written position papers and pastoral letters on almost every issue that you can imagine. The list is as long as my arm. And yet we've been silent on this particular issue. And many of our pastors, particularly those under the age of 40, have come to me in the last year as I've been traveling and visiting our churches and our presbyteries and said, why is the church silent on this one of the most pressing issues of our day? Well, part of the reason is because it's so difficult to have a conversation around this important issue. People seem to line up on one side or the other and lob grenades at each other. But I think the EPC is capable of doing this differently. We're capable of speaking biblically, we're capable of speaking ironically, and we're capable of speaking pastorally about this important matter of the brokenness of our society. And so the intent of the national leadership team is that this pastoral letter would be thoroughly biblical, biblical in language, biblical in content, biblical in approach. And so we framed it in the sense of a pastoral letter of racial lament and hope. Lament and hope are two thoroughly biblical categories that may not do everything, but we don't need the letter to do everything. It needs to help our pastors navigate this difficult cultural moment with biblical clarity and fidelity. And so we think lament and hope will enable us to enter into that discussion and do just that. And so I hope that you would pray about that. I hope that you would come prepared to support the national leadership team's recommendation. But if you have any questions, please feel free to talk to me or to talk to others in your presbytery, perhaps, who are in positions of leadership about how it is that we can move forward together. I believe a pastoral document that is going to be thoroughly biblical is one that we can do together. I think the EPC has it in us to do this really well. And my question for us is, if not us, who? And if not now, when? We would rather not be reactionary and falling into the trap of either side of these culture wars, but we would rather be thoroughly biblical and pastoral and speaking to one of the most pressing and important issues of our day. So we look forward to having that conversation at our upcoming General Assembly, and I look forward to seeing you there.